that Eyewitness News exclusive and those documents dumped on the street, hundreds of them. They belonged to a lawyer who moved out of his office, so his landlord apparently decided to get rid of them. Confidential information about the lawyer's clients. You can just imagine. They were found on Atlantic Boulevard in the Borough Hill section of Brooklyn. Eyewitness News reporter Kimberly Richardson is there with our exclusive. Kim?
Well, Bill, that attorney vacated his office here on Atlantic Avenue back in October. And yes, he did leave a few very important things behind. A move, authorities say, that could result in disciplinary action. As for those confidential files, many hadn't seen them in years. Until now.
Hi. Here you go.
Yeah, thank you.
This was the first time I had ever met Emily Walters, but I already knew volumes about her. Past medical problems, her social security number, and how much money she received from a court settlement. It was all here in a file. There were more than 200 others sitting in an unsecured box on Atlantic Avenue for the world to see.
What had you thought happened to these boxes after your case was closed?
I thought they were discarded.
Right here, yep, early this morning.
Nat Hendricks found the files early Sunday morning while walking his dogs. Two large boxes stacked outside of this vacant law office.
The first one, I saw a person's name and address, and then I saw a date of birth and then a social security number. And then I closed the file.
And called us. We discovered endless pages of confidential information about clients, details about their lawsuits. All seemed to date back to the late 1990s. Still, we were able to track down three people using their own information, and one name kept popping up, Nita Maswin, the attorney who handled all of these cases.
There's doctor signatures, there are people signatures, everything. It's outrageous.
According to state records, his registration status in New York is delinquent. So how did these boxes end up here? Something the attorney general's office is also now reviewing. The landlord of the building admitted he put them outside Saturday. He tells me he had made arrangements for pickup on Sunday. Still, Tim Moore, who specializes in identity theft, points out if the documents had fallen in the wrong hands, it would have been a gold mine.
You could take one of the many credit card applications that come about, fill that out, mail it in, and you now become that individual.
According to rules of conduct, attorneys are obligated to properly dispose of clients' files. Experts say shredding is the best. If all else fails...
You ask them how they're going to dispose of it at the end. Ask if maybe the files can come back to you.
Never assume they've been taken care of. As for the landlord, by law, he also should have properly gotten rid of those confidential files, he could be fined up to $5,000. For now, we're live in the Borough Hill section of Brooklyn. Kimberly Richardson, Channel 7, Eyewitness News.
Kimberly.